Welcome to a video today. We're doing the new Teams Yealink phone. So this is an Android-based phone. This is for the new Teams operating system and phone. So you're going to log into your phone just like you do a computer. It'll come up with the Teams login and you will log in with your email address. So that's your username at oaklandchn.org and your Windows password. And that'll log you into Teams, and it'll stay logged into Teams on that phone basically forever, or until your password expires, then you have to re-authenticate on the phone. The advantage of having a phone that you can sign in and sign out of is that you can sit down at any phone, anywhere, at any location, and sign in as yourself, and then receive and your calls and listen to your voicemail and do everything as if you were you, just like sitting down at a computer and logging in. You log into the phone and it becomes you. So that's the basics of the Teams. So here I'm gonna just go through and show you the physical attributes of this Yealink 56A. So the 56A on the keypad, you know, has your standard, you know, receiver, nothing special with that. Then the buttons that it has here, if you're in a call and you wanna put the caller on hold, this is the hold button here. So it has a like the pause with the phone, so that puts an incoming call that you have on hold, and then they'll be listening to the hold music in the background. The button over here is, it's an email, but what it's really designating is voicemails. So if you click on this on the Yealink phone, the screen will change over to the voicemail screen where you can listen to or read, because it does transcriptions on the voicemails, or delete messages from your voicemail message box. So this is just shortcut keys to hold, shortcut key to the voicemail box. All of these functions can be done on the touch screen. These buttons are just shortcuts on the physical phone to do these features or get you to those. The call over here is another shortcut button. This is for call transfer. So if you click on this button, it will put the person on a brief hold, and then you will be able to transfer a call to another user by looking them up in the global address list. So you're going to transfer by name. You'll look up the person's name, just like you do in Teams on the desktop. That does the basic transfer, what we call, you know, the basic transfer. If you want to do a warm and fuzzy transfer where you're talking to someone first and then bringing them over, you have to do that on the LCD screen that you see in the next video. All the buttons are standard, nothing special there. There's a headphone button, so if you actually have a set of headphones that you're using, you can use that and switch over to your headset and take the call privately. This is your mute button over here, so if you want to mute the call because you're having a conversation or somebody steps in your office, just mute that and the person on the other side won't be able to hear you through the handset or through the headset or via any other means. And this little button here with the recycling arrows going left to right, or right to left, that is redial. That will redial the last number. So you get a busy, hang up, redial. So that's your redial button here. And then this is your speakerphone. Because it's a normal phone, you have your speakerphone function, so you can go to speaker mode and then go off. That's it for the buttons. And then the headset that I was talking about is actually one of the nice things is the Logitech headsets that we gave out to people, those do not work on the physical phone. You have to use specifically the ones that match the brand of the phone. So you do have to use these Yealink. These are the ones with the single earpiece, and they have the USB cord on them for the computer. This headset will actually plug directly into the back of the phone, up on just directly behind the screen. And these will work both on your PC. So if you want to use it on your PC for Relias training, you want to use it for Teams on your PC because that's more fully functional, that works too. Or you can actually plug it into the telephone and use it for dual duty. So that is a nice feature that you can use this standard headset. And you notice on this headset, there's a little bit more functionality because you have the mute button, you have the volume button, but one of the nice things, and this also works on the computer or on the phone, you have a call answer button. So you can quickly just sit there and click on that button and answer the call. One thing to note for people that are on hunt groups, or they now call the hunt group, it's now called a call queue. When you pick up and say that you want to answer a call queue, it has to transfer that inbound caller to you from the call queue, it's about 3 to 4 seconds before you get that person. So don't start saying hello, hello, hello right away. Wait about 3 to 4 seconds and count in your head, and then that person will be connected to you. You actually see the transferring on the physical phone itself. So that's everything about the physical aspects of the phone and using the buttons. The next video please watch is we're gonna do everything on the screen, the touch screen. It's a 7-inch screen.